Dear students, welcome to the geography class. Let's start chapter number 1, Human Geography, Nature and Scope. In this chapter, we'll study about human geography. Let's recall some important terms which you have read in 11th standard. Like, what is geography? It is the study of Earth. And we can divide it into two parts, physical geography and human geography.
There is also a third type of geography known as biogeography, in which we study about flora and fauna. It is also related to a topic.
In physical geography, we study about geomorphology, climatology, hydrology, soil geography. The meaning of geomorphology, the study of landscapes. Climatology, we study about weather, climate, types, and different regions. Hydrology, we study about realms of water over Earth's surface, including water bodies. Soil geography, the study of different types of soils, fertility status, distribution, and its use. And in human geography, we'll study about the relationship between physical and human world. Or you can say that it is the study of different patterns and processes that shape the human societies. First of all, what is human geography? According to LNC Sample, human geography is the study of the changing relationship between the unresting man and the unstable earth. Here, the unresting man stands for the man who is always trying to make changes to the environment. And unstable earth includes the changes which take place continuously on the surface of the earth, also known as geomorphic processes, which you have already read in 11th standard. In human geography, we also study about how people make places, how we organize space and society, how we interact with each other in places and across the space, and how we make sense of others and ourselves in our locality, region, and world. Now, read these underlined lines. Human geography studies the relationship between the physical or natural and the human world. This is the definition of human geography, which I have already explained in slide 2nd and 3rd. Now come to these two underlined lines where you will read that you will realize that geography got subjected to dualism. Here, dualism means two aspects for a single subject. In geography, single subject, we read two aspects. One is environmental side and the other is social factors side. Now, last these underlined lines, you'll find that nature and human are inseparable elements and should be seen holistically. Means we can't see nature and human separately. So these two are interconnected. Here, when we read this paragraph, you'll see that we talk of the face of the earth, eye of the storm, mouth of the river, snout or nose of the glacier, neck of the isthmus, and profile of the soil. All these are known as metaphors. In these lines, some physiographic structures have been compared with human body. Similarly, regions, villages, towns have been described as organisms. German geographer described the state or the country as a living organism. Networks of road, railways, and waterways have often been described as arteries of circulation. So here you will find some definitions of human geography. Thank you, students. Now we will continue the chapter in next lecture.